Matthew Warts, and I'm an extraordinary swagtastic bacteriologist.
Hi, I'm Felix Joseph, and I'm just as swagtastic and also a bacteriologist.
And hi, I'm Austin, and I'm the greatest bacteriologist to ever live.
Today we will be talking about a previously isolated bacteria that was found in the Lechugilla caves of New Mexico.
What's interesting about these bacteria is that they have incredible resistance to a multitude of industrial-strength antibiotics.
And although these bacteria are cut off from the outside world, they somehow still have resistance to doses of antibiotics that could be easily lethal to other bacteria.
We're about to show you actual footage of our first encounters with this bacteria.
This cave is too rad for human eyes. View discretion is advised.
I'm going to start talking in an Australian accent now. I cannot control the excitement. Mate. Boomerang.
We're about to enter the cave. It's so old, I've already aged. 4 million years.
Good God.
Now let's go in.
Cave is pretty old. What was that?
Oh my God. It's just a bacteria, guys.
It's okay. The Lechugilla.
Yeah.
Let's go head back to the lab.
Dude, this is scary. Oh my God.
Safe back in our lab. Let's take a closer look on what we just saw.
This bacteria has been seen to be in the KKK. This bacteria here has been seen to have been isolated in the cave for approximately 4 million years, according to our estimates.
It's only been about 60... Now that we're safe back in the lab, let's take a minute to look at what we just saw.
This bacteria here seems to have been isolated in the cave for approximately 4 million years, according to our sources.
It's only been about 60 to 70 years since the first antibiotics were developed to fight these monsters.
In order to develop an antibiotic, the strain of DNA must first be closely studied.
Look at this thing. Isn't it terrifying?
Now we're going to test which antibiotics we've created can kill this monster.
Perhaps with the use of physical harm.
Has it worked? Still alive. Test the bat. It's a wonder these bacteria didn't recently come to fruition, because they already have resistance to the most powerful antibiotics known to this outside world.
What we don't know about that unseen world is often terrifying because of the very puzzling aspects of the very small things that are very complex.
Scientists who study bacteria like me and my other colleagues could have a serious problem where we hit the wall. In regards to antibiotic efficiency and outbreak prevention.
What can be learned from this discovery is that genetic resistance to antibiotics can simply be found in nature, without the interference or development of resistance. Dr. Gerry Wright of McMaster University in Ontario, Canada, says, "The resistance hinted that antibiotic resistance genes were not the product of modern medicine, but an ancient part of nature."
Now, scientists will soon discover that the resistant genes in nature will soon threaten the effectiveness of newly produced drugs.
Scary, isn't it? Well, it looks like we're running out of time, guys. Until next time, signing off, this is Dr. Matthew Watts of Swag and Bacteriology.
And this is Dr. Felix Joseph of Swag Bacteriology and Indianology.
And this is Dr. Austin Moyer of more swag, bacteriology, and germinology.